In this video, we will talk about multi-factor authentication or MFA and how to use Twilio's Verify APIs to implement MFA in your web and voice application. MFA is also known as step-up authentication because we are taking our authentication process up a notch by adding another layer of security along with the traditional authentication mechanism. Traditional auth mechanisms like password-based authentication can be prone to frauds and data breaches because passwords can be stolen or passwords could be weakly formed, which makes them easy to guess. Which is why experts highly recommend implementing MFA to heighten the security of your application. Multi-factor authentication is the process which requires the user to enter more information than just the password in order to gain access to the application. You must have experience while accessing some applications that after the usual login process, it sends the OTP or one-time passcode to your phone number and the application waits while you receive and enter the OTP. After OTP verification, the application becomes accessible to you. OTP is not only the way to implement MFA. We can use push notification, biometrics, or physical devices like RSA token for that additional security factor. We will cover OTP-based MFA in this video. Twilio has a great set of APIs for MFA implementation to send and verify OTP. These APIs are called as Twilio Verify APIs. Using these APIs, you can send an OTP on SMS, phone call, WhatsApp, and email. In this video, we will show you two use cases. One, where we integrated Twilio Verify APIs with telephony, that is, we dial into interactive voice response or IVR and get authenticated using OTP. And second, where we have a simple web interface integrated with Twilio Verify APIs to allow users to access the welcome page after successful OTP authentication. Before the demo, let's take a look into how we have implemented MFA into telephony using Twilio platform and APIs. As you can see from the system design, when the caller calls the IVR application, the call lands on Twilio voice platform. There are many telephony specific components and protocols involved here. We'll not touch upon that. So in Twilio voice platform, a controller application is configured in webhook setting. Think of this as an application start URL, which means anytime a call is received by Twilio platform, this controller application will be invoked. Let's call this controller as verify controller. Verify controller is written using sparkjava framework. When verify controller is invoked, we extract the caller's phone number using ANI, automatic number identification. So now we know the phone number from which the user is calling. Now we ask the user if they want to receive OTP on SMS or WhatsApp. After the user chooses the channel for OTP, we form the request payload for Twilio's Verify API using the channel name along with the user phone number in E164 format, that is, plus followed by country code, followed by phone number. We then invoke the Verify API, which sends the OTP to the user. Then the caller is prompted to enter the OTP received on their phone number. Once the user enters the OTP in IVR, we invoke Verify Controller, which in turn calls Verify API to check if the user provided OTP is correct. If the value of the status attribute in Verify API response is equal to approved, we pass the authentication and allow user to proceed in the IVR. On a side note, the length of OTP is configurable in Twilio. We have set OTP length to 6 digits. Also, to consume Verify APIs, we first need to create a verification service. A verification service is a set of common configurations used to create and check verifications. Creating a verification service is a one-time activity. For more details on Twilio Verify APIs, please check the links provided in the description below. We will now see the demo of our use case where we call into IVR channel and receive an OTP on SMS for authentication. For this, we will dial into IVR. IVR will ask if we want to receive OTP on SMS or WhatsApp message. We will choose SMS. After that, OTP will be sent on the phone number from which this call has been made. We are using Google Voice here, so we will use Google Voice console for both making the call and receiving the OTP. Our application is not running right now, so we are going to start it.
You have a trial account. You can remove this message at any time by upgrading to a full account. Press any key to execute your code.
Welcome to TechnoCouple VoiceBot. To continue this call, we would like to authenticate if it's really you. We will send an OTP on your cell number. Please press 1 if you want the OTP sent as SMS or press 2 if you want it on WhatsApp. All right. Sending the OTP as regular SMS. Once you receive, please enter the 6-digit code. Thank you. You have been verified.
As you saw in the demo, after we entered the OTP received on SMS, our application authenticated the caller by calling Twilio's Verify API. If the user enters an invalid OTP, then IVR will not authenticate the user. It will ask user to retry. Let's see how.
You have a trial account. You can remove this message at any time by upgrading to a full account. Press any key to execute your code.
Welcome to TechnoCouple VoiceBot. To continue this call, we would like to authenticate if it's really you. We will send an OTP on your cell number. Please press 1 if you want the OTP sent as SMS or press 2 if you want it on WhatsApp. All right. Sending the OTP as regular SMS. Once you receive, please enter the 6-digit code. Sorry, you are not verified. Please re-enter your OTP as received, 1 digit at a time. Thank you. You have been verified.
Now let's quickly see the use case of receiving OTP on WhatsApp when the user calls the IVR.
You have a trial account. You can remove this message at any time by upgrading to a full account. Press any key to execute your code.
Welcome to TechnoCouple VoiceBot. To continue this call, we would like to authenticate if it's really you. We will send an OTP on your cell number. Please press 1 if you want the OTP sent as SMS, or press 2 if you want it on WhatsApp. All right. Sending the OTP on your WhatsApp. Once you receive, please enter the 6-digit code. Thank you. You have been verified.
So that was about receiving OTP on SMS and WhatsApp for authenticating the IVR user. Now let's see the integration of Twilio Verify APIs with web application. Design-wise, it's similar to telephony integration, except that there is no webhook configuration in Twilio platform. Our front-end is directly integrated with springboot backend by calling REST API. In this case, when we try to access a web application, we get an OTP on a phone call for user authentication. This outbound call to the user is initiated by Twilio platform internally as soon as we request Twilio to deliver OTP by phone call using our web application. Now let's see the integration of Twilio Verify APIs with web application. On the left side of the screen, we have the actual phone simulated on the screen. On the right side, you can see our landing page. User needs to be logged in to access the welcome page as indicated by the message here. Let's log into our portal. It takes us to authentication page where we can choose to receive OTP on either SMS, WhatsApp or phone call. We are going to select phone call option, which means we will get an automated call on the provided phone number and OTP will be provided to us using text to speech. I'm selecting India's country code, then the 10-digit mobile number, now let's select the channel phone call, and after we click the send OTP button, Twilio's verification API is called and it initiates the phone call to the user. And when answered, we can hear automated voice which tells us the 6-digit OTP.
Hi, to hear your phone verification code for Techno Couple, press 9. Thank you. Your code is 9 1 1 0 9 3. Again, 9 1 1 0 9 3. One last time, 9 1 1 0 9 3. Goodbye.
So we entered our OTP and clicked on verify. So OTP was verified successfully. Using Twilio's verification check API, which verifies if the user provided OTP matches with the generated one, and we are redirected to our welcome page. Similarly, we can have OTP sent to SMS or WhatsApp channel, which will be similar to what we have demoed for telephony integration earlier in this video. That's all for now. We will see you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.